So I just really have to move on. So I decided to do just another session to until 10 o'clock in the evening. Because there's so much work to do, and if I don't do it, then this will never get finished. Really, so much work, unbelievable. So 2050 execute. Let's see where we left off. So this one is basically we don't really have to, probably don't have to confine this, so we can skip this one on the top. Oops. But here we have accession and it's running grep. We can also skip that, we don't want to confine grep. So here we have GNOME VFSD. We need to take care of this one. And it's run by Dbus. So let's just move on. It's really simple work now. It's just doing it. Do it, do it, do it, do it. So, copy and paste as much as possible. So I'll just call this GVFSD. And then go to the type enforcement file and then just move on. Copy, paste. GVFSD. And then don't really have to think about this, you just have to basically confine all these services, or most of them. So it's just a matter of typing and doing it. And these are actually run by Dbus. So I need to take care of that as well. We need to take out dbusd, and I'm going to copy and paste this as well, because every time I touch the keyboard I make a typo. Seems to be it. Build. Actually, first get the path from the build install. Then restore con, and then try it, and then this one should also be confined, or at least, yeah, well, not confined, but it should have a private type identifier. Restore config log out of this one here. Log out. And all this stuff is probably also run by our friend XDM, so we'll probably need XDM, allow XDM as well. See, this is XDM dbus actually, so we need to allow that as well, and we had a way to do that. Oh shit. Man, I fucked that up. This is it, yeah. So now, nano XDM TE, and remove some stuff. Just remove all this crap. And then this basically damn, I managed to mess that one up as well. Okay. /21/11 grep execute less. No matches. Okay, do it again. Now we have a long list again. Accession is running that command grep, and then we have Fuzzy, but Fuzzy is actually getting run by GVFSD. So we're going back to our file. Fuzzy. And then it done. And these long types is a bad idea, but it's the least of my worries right now. So it's not actually DBus running it, it's DVSB running it. If I'm not overlooking anything, build. Need to restore the context. Out. Now shouldn't be making any mistakes now. So that's fine. That's fine. Kill that stupid command that's probably still there. And then get see if we get any. We have fuser mount. So basically what we need to do here we could actually just go back to fuser mount here. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. So let's just take out that. So we have this fuser mount domain. Where is it? Basically what we can do is the DVFS is running it. Now I forgot which DVFS. DVFSD is running it. What we can do now is basically extend that. GVFS. Copy that. Copy it. Then we should take out that. Same for here. The nice thing is that if you develop all in one policy, you don't have to deal with optional policy. Believe you me, that is a big advantage. Although, on the other hand, disadvantage is of course that there's no modularity and there's no organization. Comes hard to maintain, especially if you have like 50,000 rules. Then yeah, and that's already taken. They should actually take care of that as well. Damn, it's actually Fuzzy that's doing this. So I made a mistake. Shit, I knew something was not right. The Fuzzy type was at that point not running in the right domain, but it was Fuzzy because I saw it from the command. So in that sense I just knew that it was that. And it's clear. Let's log in. that grab stuff, and here we have that Atsby lunch, which is run by Debus. So I'll just call that Atsby, Atsby. Okay, work, just work, hard work. Just hard work. Atsby. Keep it simple. TE. Now I shouldn't use the last one because that's not really the right thing. This one should be brutal. Atsby Buzz Lunch, something like that. And I'll just call it Atsby. So I'll just copy. Keep working, 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 working. Don't slack. The more you slack, the longer it's gonna take. Oh, and it's actually run by Buzz. Debuzz. So, gonna have to change that as well. If I just space it the right block of policy, then that would save me a lot of time. But for some reason, I just don't do that. Maybe I'll learn soon. Would be nice. Then DBSD underscore. Get the FC file again. We're going to restore it from this command. Restore. Going to shut this, log this off, log out. Then we're going to take a look at 28, no, take 27, and it's clear. That's nice, but now we're having issues here again. So it's not so nice at all after all. Let's have a look at this again. We're having xdmdbusd, xdmdbusd, dbusexecd. Yeah, we need to actually append that out it to allow r, and then just my XDM TE. Right. And then just get over that again. That's how we do it. So now we have, well, not clean, but 29. Let's kill that one process. Let's see if that's even there. These args, grab my login you. Yeah, see that VDA agent just hanging there. Kill all you, my login user. Now it's gone. It's clean. Let's go on and log in again. Yeah, that's the wrong password. Still have half an hour left, and then I'll stop for today because it sucks. So this grab, and here we have ATSP actually launching Dbus. Why is XP actually launching Dbus? Well, that's fine, I guess. So my login user XP Dbus exactly, and it's executing, and it's executing no transition, and then it's getting the registry. So first we're going to transition from ATSP to Dbus, and then back from Dbus to ATSP registry, ATSP 2. Phew! Okay. So ATSP to Dbus. Where's my Dbus stuff? There we go. My login user ATSP ATSP. Call it what you want to. Actually, I'm doing something wrong here. Yeah, I'm actually doing it wrong. No, I'm not. Getting kind of confusing with all these things running, other things, and but I think I'm still on point. still the same. Yep. And then basically we're going to have to take care of that at speed 2. At speed 2, which is also which is run by at speed, but it's DBS Daemon. So no, it's run by DBS Daemon. Yeah. FC. I'll just call this at speed 2 for simplicity, or yeah. Below, and this is Divas, right? Yeah, right, so that's cool. That's V2 registry D. Registry D. And I'll just call that V2, let's keep it real simple. This that's between actually then just restore con stuff, don't forget. Restore con this stuff here. Copy, get out of there. Install. Restore con turbos. Okay, lock this mother out. The outsource dance again, it's 2037. Now might need 36 there. And we have XDM doing the dance again. So that's basically out it to allow R and then my XDMTE seems right. Then install that again. Actually build that again. And then install that again. Then kill the processes and start over again. Maybe we might be able one or two processes if I can keep this up. Kill all. Yep. Okay, are we clear? At 3.8. Yep, we are clear. Let's do this. And let's see what we got. These can be ignored, and we have IAM settings check here. And this one is actually ran directly by the user. So IMSET Jack, MZ Jack, yeah, something like that. MZ Jack. Okay, whatever. Keep the pace. Insert check, yeah, that sounds nice. Now open a TE file and I'll try to pick up something what that applies a little bit. This applies. Set check like a sim nice and simple. Yeah, inset check, that's what it is. Let's see, I do an extra underscore there. Just a lot of work. Nothing interesting about it. That's a lot of work. And this, these are just the defaults things that you need to just log in. Can you imagine all these programs that you can run? Let's see. All these rules in the policy database. Slows down your system for sure. And this is just single user. But if you're basically using these prefix domains for each and every user, then stuff gets really nasty, really fast. But it's nice, it gives you that flexibility. Let's get that path there. Copy and build this stuff and install it and then restore on it and then just go all over the stuff again step by step, taking it slow, taking it easy. Restore con the paste and then let's just kill or log off, log out, back to the screen and let's just kill that one. Let's see what we got. So we're on 43, so I'll just keep that on 42. See if we have something. No, we don't, actually. So that's nice. So we can basically just log in right away. And move on to the next one. Move along to the next trick. Okay, so this is that grab stuff, and here we have pulse audio. That's weird. That's really weird. See, we actually. Let's have a look. Peace out. Then grab 10, 12. So we still have that noon session. Not confined, but here you have the XP stuff. For some reason, it just doesn't die. We have Fuzi. So we're slowly but surely actually advancing. But this Pulse Audio shit, I know there's something fishy with that. So I wonder why I'm not actually transitioning to Gnome session. So let's just take care of that first. LS user lib exec. Of course, Gnome session isn't there. Then it's user bin, ls user bin Gnome session, and this is going to be my last one for today. I already had enough. I can get this one done, then I'm happy. And I'll call this G session. Save that. Go to type enforcement file. And do I have the last one? Yeah, the last one is cool. Gnome session paste. Gnome session, and then just G session. G session. See if I can get that thing to run in that domain. For some reason, audit doesn't log it, and I'm not sure what that means. But I'm a little bit sure that actually this might actually change the whole scenario, to be sure of, to be frank. This might actually change the whole scenario. That's why you really should work your stack from the top, because else it's going to get really messy, and it might actually be the case now, so we'll see. And I'm afraid that's right, so that means that this work's going to be more than I thought. Just because audit doesn't friggin' show it. Kay. tonight. Just get distracted. You'll see that this stuff probably gets run by GNOME session instead of the user. So I'm gonna have to probably change all that stuff. Session 2149 audit to allow R my XDM TE looks about right. Build it again, install it again, and let's see how this affects everything. Kill all. Where are you? Yep. 24/9, yeah, we already had that. We're at 51. And we're clean. Let's run this again. And now let's see what all changed. Probably the whole scenario has changed, I'm not sure, but actually not. Actually not. Well, actually no. Let's just how to allow that to get an overview. See, this session is actually doing the Pulse Audio. It's also running the keyring daemon. Let's just check it out. PS, how that looks. So now this session and keyring daemon still runs properly. So basically we need to see session runs a lot of crap. Session runs shell and here, and the session probably runs dbus also back. Messy, but fortunately most of this stuff runs the way it's supposed to. So what was I saying? Oh yeah, right, so session D actually runs, G session actually runs in keyring diamond. Does it? G session keyring diamond. Yeah, it's actually running moon keyring diamond. So go to the GKRD and basically do the dance. My login user G session, and then T and close that. Yeah. I ain't got time for fun and games right now. I'm working hard on finding this crap. Working overtime. But it's nice to see slowly advancing the process list, slowly getting more and more confined, or at least more and more private types, because we haven't actually added any rules yet. Yeah, so this should be taking care of that. Make it. Install it and just go through all this stuff again. And in the meanwhile, I'll just make myself available if everything works right. So it's installing, isn't it? So let's log out. No online contacts. Okay, so why did you email me? Let me first check out the out search. We're on 56 right here. And we're clean. Let's kill that thing. Okay, let's see where this gets us. And we have a whole bunch of new stuff. So that TR stuff, we can ignore that. Check accelerated, we could probably not ignore that because it's running. Or I'm going to probably leave it here because we're nice round at an hour and it looks okay. It looks okay. Slowly but surely we're getting there. So So we have an awful lot of G session now. We're getting there. So I'll leave it here for now.